Praise be to Jesus Christ. My dear brothers and sisters, welcome to Vajanamrutam. Few days ago, one young man asked me, Father, why Jesus is very strict about sexual matters? And he said, Jesus said, one who look at a woman has already committed adultery with her in the heart. I told him, my dear brother, when you read the word of God, read it carefully. It comes Matthew 5:28. There we read, anyone who look at a woman with lust has already committed adultery with her in the heart. So not simply looking, it is lust with lust. What does it mean, lust? Lust means passionate desire for something. So here, Jesus says in the context of sex. So, of course, it becomes sexual matters. Otherwise, it is a passionate desire for something, maybe money, maybe power, anything. So that passionate desire, that defiles human heart. Jesus doesn't look at the action of a person, but he looks at the heart, heart's condition. Heart should be pure. So that is important for Jesus. So even the woman who was caught in adultery was brought to Jesus. He did not judge that woman, but he criticized indirectly people who brought her there, because he knew their heart was not pure. So he said, let anyone among you without sin stone at her at first. Without sin, anyone among you without sin. So, my dear brothers and sisters, our heart should be pure. That is important, not the action. Not the action, our heart should be pure. So excessive desire for something, maybe for power, maybe for money, that defiles human heart. So free from all this bondage, bondage of sex, bondage of power, bondage of wealth. Of course, these all are the gifts of God. God has given as a gift, sex, power, money, everything. But when God gave to you, he had a definitive purpose of it. Sex, it is the exchange of love in the marital status. Power, for serving other people. Money, for the sustenance of day-to-day life. So, everything has got a definitive purpose. When we go beyond it, it will be a burden for you. So, otherwise, it is a gift. We can enjoy it, no problem. But in this context, we have to make use it. Don't go beyond it. When it goes beyond it, it becomes a burden in the heart, and it defiles your heart, and you cannot enjoy this life. If you want to enjoy this life, remove all kinds of this passionate desire. Even Buddha said, desire is the cause of all suffering. When there is excessive desire for anything, that really gives you pain, suffering. So, otherwise we can enjoy every moment in the life. I used to meditate morning, looking at the sunrise. So how beautiful it is when we see that sunrise. Just observe around you the nature. So very colorful sunrise and the beautiful songs of birds and a gentle touch of a breeze. Everything will give you joy and happiness. But your heart should be pure and holy. When you are burdened, when you are filled the heart with all these kinds of passionate desires, you cannot enjoy it. So, my dear brothers and sisters, remove it. Remove all these unnecessary things, excessive desires, passionate desires, and begin to enjoy this life. Every moment in this life, you will be able to enjoy. I shall pray for you and pray for me. May Almighty God bless you. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.